Here they come.
Good.
Highball freight, number 56. Block. Entire line. Impassable.
Hold all trains.
Get me Dan Thorne. Port all along the main line.
Oh, why don't somebody get me Dan Thorne? He's the only man can handle this. I'm trying to get him. Half my paperwork ruined again because he's out tramping the yard when he should be here to give me authority.
What's coming off around here?
If you guys play railroad anymore today,
there's a landslide, the new cut. The entire division is held up
right
at the peak of traffic. My schedule's all ripped to pieces, and we've had to hold up the Limited.
Hold up the Olympian? Will you off your nut? Tell her to come through.
What's the half a mountain sledding on that track?
I'll clear the track. Don't stand there looking at me. Lift those red ports and keep traffic moving. You, blast the boiler room to blow the whistle and get the red crew out.
Okay.
You, phone Ed Ryan. I won't be home to dinner tonight. Give me a piece of that. You office guys, put the Olympian in the hole.
Looking at labor like that, it's made a hobo out of me.
Can you imagine? On a day like this?
The trouble with labor is the work that's connected with it. Now, I figured that work is for workers. Oh, why bother your head about it?
Hey, Joe, keep this bug over, will you?
Listen, Dan, we can't make it. We've got to send back for more men.
What? Leave this line blocked another hour? Not on your life.
Say, listen, there's not a man in 10 miles.
Caram, boys, caram.
Come on, come on.
Mr. Thorne, I'm a conscientious objector to manual labor in any form.
Get over there, get over there.
I yield only to superior force.
Come.
Well, how did I overlook you?
Come out of there.
Get over there and get to work.
What makes you think I will?
I got a couple of very good arguments for that.
Listen, I work when I want to, and I don't want to now.
No?
Over this way, over this way.
Oh, Mr. Thorne, this is an extremely dangerous spot.
Right here.
Get over there.
All clear, Dan.
Okay.
Take it away!
Joe. See that fella down there? Put him in the caboose and throw a feed into him.
But Dan, he's only a tramp.
I don't know. There's something about that guy. Take him along.
All right. Hey, a couple of you fellas come with me.
Division Super 2, and he was about your size.
Well, you must think you're as tough as I am.
Well, if you and me is blowing enough smoke for now, I'll be on my way.
Now, some people would let you do just that. Me, I'm going to give you a chance to put some of them guns into a job.
Work on a railroad again? No chance. The rent's against you, Super.
On this road and for me. I'm Dan Thorne, and what I say goes around here. That means everybody, see?
Yeah. Everybody but me.
Joe. I'd like to have a new man for your cellar packer job.
You know engine?
Sure, used to work on the Lake Division. Go ahead and meet Joe Gary, the roundhouse foreman.
Oh, glad to know you. Dan said you're all right. It's okay with me. Get busy on the big boy here. It's next out.
Hey, ah, boy, there's your job.
Yeah. So you think I'm working, huh?
If them jail boxes ain't greased in half an hour, it'll burn the heart out of you, big fella.
Sure. But I ain't working, understand? I ain't working. That's a fine way to leave an engine.
Shop down and see you later.
All right.
Hey, Dan. I was wondering if I could lay off on the next run.
Why, Tom, you ain't put in for anything like that in 20 years.
Well, you see, well, I...
Oh, it's the wife. Ain't she no better yet?
She's worse, Dan. Much worse.
So you got everything you need? You got a good doctor?
Yes, but I'm just a little frightened, Dan.
You go right back to her, and don't you let me see you around these yards till she's absolutely all right.
Thanks.
Go on.
Hey, you know, Dan, if anything happens to Tom, he'll hit the booze again, sure.
He knows better than that. Why, I'd have to rule him off the road.
But you know what he used to be.
That's right. Chuck, keep an eye on him. And if anything happens, let me know quick.
You're always thinking of me, ain't you? Sure, no man had a better daughter than I have.
The birds will hear you.
Look here, will you? The Donahue brothers are giving away a kitchen table and two chairs to every newly married couple this month. Now, that's something for you to look forward to.
Well, that's quite an inducement, isn't it?
It is. I must show this to Dan.
Oh! Don't you dare!
Let go. Why shouldn't I show it to him? He's a man that understands. Where is he? I haven't seen him today.
What time is it?
Oh, there you are. Another minute you'd be late.
Not a chance. You wouldn't think I'd be late with you waiting for me, Mary, would you? Hey, I'm going to enter a complaint. Somebody's getting a lot of attention around here besides me.
Sure, go on with you. You wouldn't be jealous of her own father, would you?
Wouldn't I? Say, I'm likely to be jealous of anybody.
What's that?
Oh, yes. Say, Mary, I want you to do something for me. I want you to go down the roundhouse. I got a new man down there. He's a floater, and his name is Doyle. Give him this bundle and this note and see what he does, huh?
Now, Dan, I wish you wouldn't bother your head about those tramps. You know, it never turns out right.
Mary, a fella can go wrong a dozen times. But if you're right once, it makes up for all the rest. Will you do it?
Well, all right.
Well, I got here just in time, didn't I?
You did that.
I did.
Answer now?
Yeah.
All right, just tell Thorne there's no chance. I'm quitting.
I thought you would.
Why, wait a minute. What do you mean you thought I would? What makes you think I'm a quitter? You think I'm here because I like it? Well, I'm not, and I'm leaving. I'm not gonna...
All right. Suit yourself.
Wait a minute. Hey, wait a minute. What do you mean, suit myself? We got our kind.
Oh, she's a lucky girl. I've often said it, she's a lucky girl to be marrying a railroader and a fine-looking man, too.
Hey, hey, stop throwing them apples. Give me a match, will you?
But you are, Dan. You are. Maybe not exactly handsome, but...
No.
But handsome is as handsome does.
Not exactly handsome. Why, my pan looks like a street before they laid the pavement down.
You wouldn't find Mary saying a thing like that. Oh, you're going to make her happy, Dan.
I never failed to do anything I want to do yet.
You sure haven't, boy. You're always kingpin amongst us, even in the old days. And ever since I got my smash, and you started to take care of
pipe
me and
down,
Mary.
Pipe down.
Why, you're more than just a man to us. You.
Hey, stop it. You have me blushing.
Maybe I didn't say the right words, boy, but you know how I feel, don't you?
You don't owe me a thing. If it had been the other way around, you'd have done the same thing to me. Sit still, lad. I'll see who it is.
Yeah, this is the right place. Come on in.
Well, how do you feel?
Okay, here.
Come and have a bite to eat.
No, thanks.
Wait a minute. Meet Ed Ryan. We live here together. Ed, this is Larry Doyle.
Hi.
Glad to meet you.
You better put in some fuel. We just took off the nose bag ourselves, but there's plenty of grub on the stove yet. And before you do that, maybe you better go upstairs and clean up a little. I left some clothes out for you. When you're decent, why, come right on down.
Thanks. I guess I need them at that.
Go on. It's to the left. Hilda?
Yeah?
Set another place on the table and keep supper hot on the stove, will you?
Yeah. Hey, Phil.
All right.
Is that the boomer engineer you were talking about?
Yeah, that's the kid. Should have seen him talk back to me. Try to fight me and him 2 days away from his last square meal. He's a game kid. I know that kind. They wind up in a jail or a general manager's job.
Yeah, in a jail, most likely. I never saw one of those floaters yet that panned out right.
Ain't you?
No, I haven't.
Well, you're looking at one right now. Say, if I hadn't got kicked in the pants by a couple of old rails like you, I'd have been a floater yet. That kid's gonna make a good hothead. Say, what's happened to Mary? Is she coming down?
She's upstairs primping up for you.
I live here.
That's a good idea. Well, aren't you going to say you're glad to see me?
Well, I will say you look a little better.
And of course you're glad to see me.
If you insist, of course I'm glad to see you.
Of course you're glad to see me.
No, 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 Ed, I've got to get back to the shops. You tell Mary I'll see her later.
Come on.
Sugar.
All right.
Hilda, see that the food on the plate is kept hot.
Yeah,
it
will.
Where's Mr. Thorne?
He's gone to the shops. Sit down.
Oh, thanks. I wanted to thank him for these clothes. They almost fit me.
Sit down. Hilda will bring you in a bite to eat.
Well, I ain't going to eat all alone, am I?
I guess you'll have to. Dan and I have had ours. Oh, here's Mary. She hasn't had her supper yet.
Guess you thought I was never coming down.
Mr. Doyle. This is my girl, Mary.
Oh, we've been introduced before. Once by Mr. Overhauls and again by Johnny Towel.
Sure, I said, she's my girl. I should be saying, she's Dan Thorne's girl. She's going to marry Dan Thorne. Mrs. Thorne.
Yes, Mr.
Reinhardt.
Mr. Thorne is absolutely on time, I promise you. Wait a minute.
See if I can get him.
Long distance, Mr. Thorne.
Let me call me later.
What? I
can't talk to you right now. Calling later.
I tell you, I'm not going to lay any more package on that spur. Now get that. Now what? I tell you, every egg will arrive there intact if I have to lay a new roadbed all the way from here to Chicago. Good part.
O'Doyle. Dan Thorne wants you over at the office.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, as soon as I wash up.
What? Don't bother me! Imagine any man in his right mind picking up railroading as a business?
No, sir.
What?
Yes, sir.
Who asked you anyway? Here, take this over to the roundhouse foreman. No!
Ain't this nice, you coming down here to see me?
Dan, you forgot the handkerchiefs I laid out for you this
morning. Huh? So I did. See, that's thoughtful of you. It's all right, Mary. It's all right. It makes me feel kind of close to you when I see you doing little things like this.
Oh, it's nothing at all, Dan. You're the thoughtful one. Look what you've done for all of us.
Oh, it's a pleasure to do things for you, Mary. I don't like to have you running around among these tracks, but you're the only thing that seems to brighten up this tough old railroad yard, and it sort of keeps me from going off my nut sometimes. You know, I don't know if I could go through with it if I didn't look forward to seeing you.
Hey, what do you guys think you're doing down there, playing ping pong? Two digits by this company's meant to work with.
I guess I don't need to tell you how I feel about you, Mary.
Dan, I think you've been wonderful.
You want to see me?
Well, hello, kid. How are you? Yeah. I've got something for you.
Come in. Read this.
I hadn't ought to take this from you.
No, no.
I want to be moving on. I don't think I'll ever be happy around here.
What do you mean,
happy?
You're going to stick here because I tell you, see?
I guess you know what I want to say.
Oh, well, don't say it.
Hello, hello, Dan. Say, this is Chuck. Say, old Tom Johnson's wife died this morning. Yeah. He's on the loose. He's in that joint down by the lower yards. I did what I could, but after she passed away, I couldn't hold him. Okay, Dan. I'll keep it to myself.
Mary, I'm sorry. I've got to believe you. I've got a tough call, and
Dan,
I've got
to
go.
Dan, you'll be back in time for the party tonight, won't you?
Party? What party?
The old-timers' picnic.
By golly, I forgot all about it. But I can't go anyway, Mary.
Oh, you have to go, Dan.
No, I can't. This is very important. I got it. You can go with Larry.
No. No, I want to go with you.
No, 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 no. Now, listen, Barry. This is very, very... Now, you haven't got much more time to dress. You better... And say, Larry, there you are. You can be celebrating your new rating and help me out at the same time, huh? And I'll try to drop in later. Huh? That's fine. That's fine. Well, so long. So long.
I guess that settles it.
I guess it does.
Do you want to go with me?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please to the next feature on the program. That mighty spectacle presented by our own boys and on our own engine. A tug of war between two colossal moguls of the run.
I see Wall Street has dropped again today.
Scram.
The hospitality of this place is absolutely appalling.
Nobody else can stop me, huh? I'm gonna drink tonight.
I ain't here to stop you. How do you get that way?
Hey, give me a shot of that stuff, will you? Well, here's to you, Tom.
You can't do that.
Why can't I? I guess a couple of old friends can have a drink together, huh?
Yeah, but you're the boss of this here division. You've got to think of the railroad.
Well, for that matter, you're an engineer. You don't think a couple of drinks is going to hurt your throttle hand, huh?
Go on, let's make a night of it.
It's no use, Dan. I'm through. She's gone. She's all that I had. I'm through. I gotta quit, I tell you. I'm gonna quit.
Quit, huh? I never thought I'd hear Tom Johnson say a word like that. Are you turning yellow?
No, Dan, no.
Well, what else would you call it, you quitter?
Oh, but you don't understand.
Yes, I understand. Your heart's broke because your wife's gone. But do you think you're going to help matters with that stuff? We're railroad men. We got to keep the schedule. What right have we got to drink, hold the throttle, running a train with lives depend on us? No, we got to keep them trains moving. That's our religion, Tom. That's our life.
That's what Bess used to say. That's the way I felt first, when I first met her.
And that's how she'd want you to be now, Tom. That's how you are. Come on, let's get out of here.
Let's go.
I love this time of the year. Just smell those apple blossoms over by the woods.
Funny what a night like this does to you. Just look at them stars. And that moon looks like a big headlight, don't it? And that soft breeze from the river.
I never heard you talk like that before, Larry.
Well, why shouldn't I? Don't you suppose I've got feelings?
Thank you.
That was young Larry Doyle's whistle, wasn't it?
Yes. He's taking the general manager's car and the dynamometer back to the yards.
He hasn't been around here much since the old-timers' party.
No.
Dan Thorne's worked wonders in that boy, Mary.
Well, I think Larry deserves a little credit himself.
No. No. Dan Thorne was responsible. Dan Thorne, Mary. He's a great man.
I know. You needn't worry, Dad. I'm going to marry him.
And how, may I ask, did you find your way onto this train?
Mr. Thorne, I've been patronizing your road for a good many years, and I cannot understand why I should be jiggled around this railroad yard for 3 or 4 days. It's absolutely imperative that I arrive at Chicago before the 19th. Everything depends on it. Why can't you furnish me with adequate transportation to take me to my destination?
Professor, the entire road is at your service.
See that train down there?
Yeah.
That train goes straight through to Chicago.
Sir?
With my compliments.
Thank you. I shall recommend this road to all of my friends.
Thank you. Everything all right as usual. Come on up and I'll make out your report for you.
Oh,
by the way, I got what you wanted.
Huh?
You know, that
Oh, thanks.
See you later on.
Yeah.
Joe, I want to talk to you about those new horses they're bringing in.
That's been on time as regular as you have. If this happens again, I'll find it. Ain't you looking swell? Huh?
Yes.
Hey, now you can relieve me, see? I ain't much on this dancing business. Besides, gotta go over and see Ed Ryan. I got a surprise on him. Big surprise. Excuse me?
What does he mean? He's got a big surprise.
Folks.
And ladies.
I'm not much at speech making. So, I ain't gonna make no speech at all. Well, anyway, there's Stan Thorne.
Hey, come on, get out.
What he wants to tell you is that, that I'm gonna have a vacation.
Good. Well, I seem to be a kind of a popular guy around here. Everybody's glad I'm going. Well, that wasn't what I wanted. What I really wanted to say was that, oh, well, Mary Ryan and me is going to be married. Oh,
What is it? What? A washout? Dan.
A washout, huh? Well, I'm not going. I'm not going. I don't care if it's the main line. I don't care if the whole system falls apart. I wish every train on the line had gone to the ditch.
It had to happen tonight. The one night I've been sailing.
All right. I'll tell him you're not going. That's... Here, you...
Who says I'm not going? Give me that phone. Yeah, get the wrecking crew out. Fire up the wrecking train. Get all the emergency crews together. Sure, I'm coming. Hey, get your car out. You're going to drive us to the yard.
Joe, come on.
Boy.
Mary, too bad it has to be.
Well, this is a shame, Mary. I'm awfully sorry.
Yes. Yes, it's too bad.
Thank you.
Mary, don't.
Oh, I can't go through with it, Larry. I can't.
You've got to go away with me. You can't marry him. You know that, don't you? Don't you?
Oh, Larry, let's go away now. Tonight, before he knows or guesses.
No, I've got to talk it out with him. Oh. I've got to tell him.
You can't talk anything out with him. He'd kill us. Or maybe you'd kill him. Either way would be worse than crazy.
Oh, I'm no good doing this to Dan Thorne.
Don't you think it hurts me? He's taken care of us ever since I was a kid. But I can't love him that way. He'd know in the end and would hurt him more. He's iron and steel and fire. He's not flesh and blood like you and me. This is something greater than railroads, greater than him.
Yes, I guess it is. You're right. We have just time to flag the express for Chicago. Hurry, Dan, pack your things.
Thank you. Mary. It's operated from the tower.
It's no use.
This thing's like a vice. And I'm only going to get what I deserve, I guess.
Oh, no, no, Larry, no.
Now, Mary, get off the track.
No, I won't leave you.
Oh, please, Mary, get away.
No, no, I won't
leave you. Can't stay here, Mary.
No,
please,
won't.
Go on away.
No,
get off the track, please.
I won't.
I'm going to kill you. I'm going to kill you.
Dad, it's from part of the switch.
Go ahead, Dan. It's all right. I got it coming to me.
No, no, Dan. Don't. No, don't. Dad. Doctor.
It's bad.
But, Doctor, you've got to save him. There must be something.
Only a brain surgeon with complete modern equipment can help him. There's nothing like that this side of Chicago. He can't live more than 5 hours.
But our fastest run to Chicago is 7 hours. We haven't got a through train on the schedule till this afternoon.
The only chance is to get him to Chicago in 5 hours.
At gates right now.
180.
Put it up to 200.
Okay.
Oh, gee, it's tough. There must be something we can do.
Not a thing. It's a 6-hour record run. It can't be done.
I can do it.
What?
I can do it.
Why, don't you realize you couldn't keep that engine on the rails going 100 miles an hour all the way to Chicago? It can't be done.
It's got to be done. It's got to be done.
Maybe it can. Put Dan in my special. Give it right away over everything.
You bet.
In that cab.
Look here. This means sidetracking everything on the way. The Olympian, the Pioneer, the whole timetable. Why, this will cost a fortune. And all for one man.
For one man? You don't seem to understand. This isn't only Dan Thorne. It's every railroad man everywhere.
Here. Hold everything east on the division. Okay. 50 Wayburton and Hilton on the wire at once.
Right.
Red board as far east as Market City.
All right. Yeah.
Hey, give me that. Give me that.
Oh.
It's cold.
This is the last time you'll ever ride this road.
If it's any news to you, it's the last time I'll ever ride any road.
Ah, come on.
Sure, it was his own wish that he'd come back here and die in his own division. That's a funny remark for Dan Thorne to make.
I can't believe he wouldn't get well from anything if he wanted to.
I guess that's the trouble. He just doesn't want to get well.
You know what it is he wants. Wait a minute, boys. Let Mary go in first.
Hello, Mary.
Oh, Dan. Don't look at me like that.
It's all right, Mary. It's all right.
You don't understand, Dan. I've come back to you for always.
I understand. I understand.
No, Dan, no. I mean it. I'm never going to leave you again. The other was a mistake.
Hello, kid.
Thanks, Dan, for all you've done for me.
For you. You didn't think I was going to see the Limited wreck, did you? Oh. Lying like this gives a man plenty of time to figure things out. I never had so much time before. You know, people have got to marry the things they love best. You two, each other. Me, the railroad. Oh, I ain't kidding myself.
Dan. Dan.
Bad about Dan Thorn, ain't it? I hear he's all true. And he used to be a nice fella, too.
Come on, get the lead out of your feet. I'll come out there and nap that journey for a row of gondolas. There's ain't no smoking room, there's a railroad.
All true, is he?